Jeremy Nelson. In Jeremy, I am just overwhelmed with how the gifts of the Spirit operate in your life. But you started seeing miracles, but yet there was something deep, deep within him that said there must be something more. And he actually, even though he saw more than most Bible believers see, he was frustrated.
Yeah.
And he hooked up with a man by the name of Bobby Connor. And Bobby Connor started mentoring him, and he would tell him stories of things that happened to him. For instance, tell me one of the wilder stories Bobby told you.
Yeah, well, I remember, you know, one of the first times that I met Bobby, he walked up to me in a conference and said, "Hey, boy, how'd you like to travel the world with me? God says you're one of my sons." And so as he invited me to do that, you know, I started going places. One of the first places was we went to Europe, and we were there together, and we were in Holland, and as we were hanging out, he told me this story, and I mean, it just like provoked me to what I would say a holy jealousy. And you know, he started to tell me about a time that he had a dream, and he was asleep at home in his home in Texas. And anyway, in the dream, he actually was in Peru, and he was preaching the gospel from this massive stage. He was doing a healing campaign, and he gave the altar call. Many people got saved. Many people got healed. And then after the campaign was over, the Peruvian people put him on a big llama, and they said, "All right, we're going to take you down to the city and feed you." And so they went down. But in this dream, the llama actually tripped because Bobby was too big for the llama.
I can picture that.
And so the llama tripped and slid down the hill, and Bobby slid down with it. And anyway, he said that as that happened, he woke up screaming. And when he woke up screaming, he woke his wife up, and she screamed too, "What's going on?" And he said, "Oh, I was just in a dream." And so anyway, then at the beginning of the day, when he woke up later, he went back to sleep after that. He went to go get ready for his day, and he noticed that at the foot of his bed was the same clothes in the dream that he was wearing, and they were covered with llama hair and with dirt.
Now, that is supernatural. It really is. But this is what occurred, as you've explained it to me. Every time he would hear these testimonies, something would happen inside of him, and his faith would become activated to expect these things. And in fact, he gets on an airplane, and what happened?
Well, what happened is, you know, after I heard many of those testimonies, like I just shared the one with you, you know, Bobby told me something. He said, "Hey, Jeremy," he goes, "do you want to know why I keep telling you these testimonies?" I said, "Why is that?" And he said, "It's not because I want you to think I'm more spiritual than you, but it's because I'm giving you the keys to enter into the encounters yourself." He said, "The testimony of Jesus is a spirit of prophecy." And he said, "The reason why I tell you the testimonies is because it actually opens it up for you." And he said, "If you'll think about the things of God and talk about the things of God, Colossians chapter 3, verse 1, set your mind and affections on things above." He said, "If you set your mind there, then you'll have the things that are above in your life." And so he challenged me, said, "I challenge you to talk about God and watch what happens." And so me and my friend are flying from New Jersey back to Vancouver, where I was living at the time. And as we're flying back, we're just talking about God's stories. You know, we're telling testimonies of miracles and dreams and visions and encounters. And at that time, I was telling mainly Bobby's because I was just with him.
Right.
And so we get to Vancouver, and my brother Josh picks us up in my car from the airport. We get in the car and we begin to drive. And so we're so excited about the testimonies, we start telling him about the testimonies. Then all of a sudden, my friend Craig, who's in the back of the car, back seat, starts screaming,
"Oh, what's going on?
What's going on? We're in Mississippi. And I'm thinking, what?
And what?
So I look back at him and I look forward, and you know, we were driving down the Vancouver Highway. Well, all of a sudden, we're not on the Vancouver Highway anymore, Sid. We were on a normal street. There were street lights. We look to the left. There's a guy mowing the lawn. And my friend in the back screams, I know that man. I went to high school with him. This is my hometown. And my brother's driving the car, and he just looks stunned. He's like, he's trying to figure out what's going on. And so all of a sudden, I look
now,
back.
How many miles away was this from where you were?
2,700 miles.
Did you get that? He's all of a sudden transported 2,700 miles.
Yep.
We don't have to worry about gas prices going up with that type of supernatural travel.
Yeah, and you don't even have to have a current passport.
Okay, so he freaks out by what he's seeing.
So he's freaking out, and to be honest, I'm freaking out. Everybody's...
I'm freaking out. How about you?
And so I look back at him again, and when I look back again, we're right back on the Vancouver Highway.
What?
And so it was amazing because, you know, we knew that we were somewhere else, and we knew where we started from, and then we're back there. So my friend calls the guy on the cell phone that was mowing the lawn, and he says, "Hey, were you mowing the lawn just now?" And the guy tells him, "Man, I knew you're prophetic, but you're scaring me now."
Okay, then a major, major encounter happens to Jeremy in Scotland. What happened?
Yeah, I was in Scotland, and, you know, as I was praying, I was just in a time of prayer and worship, and all of a sudden I had a face-to-face encounter with Jesus. And when I say face-to-face, this is probably the only time I've ever had this. It was like Jesus appeared to me as a person. It was real. And he comes up to me, and Jesus was wearing a white robe with a blue sash, and he walks up to me.
He had Israeli colors on, by the way. Just want to point that out.
That's true. Yeah, and he walks up to me, looks me right in the eyes, and he pulls the sash back, the blue sash, and there's his heart. And his heart was on fire. It was burning. And he takes his right hand, and he touches my head, and he prays for me. And as he prays for me, it's like fire goes through my entire being, and all of my spiritual senses were heightened. They were activated. And from that moment on, there had been a real impartation of activation of all the spiritual senses, both for myself and also in meetings or places that we speak, people get activated.
I'm sensing such a presence of God right now. As a matter of fact, someone's neck was just healed in Yeshua's name. But when we come back, I believe that your spiritual senses are going to be activated. Don't go away.